Okay guys, thanks so much again. I only did a video yesterday, obviously being in recognition to that fact of my birthday. Now it's in approximately that of 6 o'clock. To be almost entirely accurate, it is 5 minutes past six. And I eventually recently came back from a lot of a smell testing club dig, which I am presenting you. Sorry, can't particularly pronounce my words correctly here today. Presenting to you in this video that's coming up. It's episode 9, the Roman numeralization for that 9 is IX, which is particularly reasonable and particularly eye-catching there. In this video I find relics, buttons, buckles, bag seals and lead. Sorry, someone's on my phone, I'll just put that on disturb. I did not disturb. I particularly enjoy doing so. I found a few relics, a couple of buttons, as you'd usually expect. A buckle, a couple of bags, well, actually only one bag seal, and an absolutely glossy of lead. On this video, I mounted my GoPro Hero of the 2014 variety, on that of the, both my spade and my, detector, and that of my head mount, and, it should be an enjoyable video as well. And, also, if you obviously enjoyed this video, go ahead and subscribe. It's obviously free, no cost or admission whatsoever, and it's particularly enjoyable, and I very much appreciate it, as obviously you may as well, but obviously reasonably it would be myself that appreciates it the most, rather than that of yourselves. But if you haven't subscribed already, all of my 91 subscribers, I very much appreciate them watching my videos regularly. So I do upload them once a fortnight, but as an exception, I've just had a club smell testing club dig, so obviously I'll upload this now. And, we were on a field that was almost entirely engulfed by that of sugar beet, I believe it is. And, I detected that it was hard detecting conditions sometimes, but, I managed to find a couple of buttons, and actually, believe it or not, possible. Viking shield boss. I'm not totally sure if it is, but if it is, then obviously you need to go to the Finds Larson officer quite immediately. And when it comes back, be particularly brilliant, circumstantially. And that'll be brilliant. And it may go to that of the English Heritage Society, or that of the British Museum, which is unlikely. But if it is, then obviously it's quite scarcity and something of value. Sorry about that. Sorry, I have to go now. But, okay, guys, in a bit. Yeah, okay, guys, we've actually found something here. But it seemed to be of some lead variety. Of medieval, possibly. Possibly later or earlier. We're not particularly sure, but that has been said to be a Roman pottery. And this is near a pre-Norman church, you can see here. There's the farm. And it seems to be, and it's right next to a particularly old, possibly medieval manor house as well. So, that seems particularly promising, so in a bit.
Thank you. intense. Yeah. Really bad. I'd say Georgian to that Victorian. So we're probably gonna catch our death. It's worse than Clint for sure. Oh mom, this is worse than Clint. It's deep, Aaron. Guys, we're actually back. In great fortunacy, I found a couple of buttons, a possible Viking shield boss, which I did not record. I'll show you actually have the roundup. Quite a few people here, actually. Not many people, only 30 people. That's a big community, 10 members of the club. I spoke to someone who's found a gold ring. I found the button, as you saw on the live drink, and the door knob from that of the manor house, possibly. That's my hypothesis for that circumstance, anyway. Someone found a William III shilling, part of a buckle. I haven't really found much. Found possible lead bullets. I don't believe it's a bullet, but it's some medieval piece of piece from something, anyway. Decimalisation, obviously. They are decimalisation. They don't have saturation, which is a small numismatic code. variety. Obviously, they were silver. They were exaggerated, but they weren't like the dodecagonal threatening bits that were in 6th grain and the dodecagonal parabolic that came out in, say, 2016, I believe. And, yep, it was dated 1874, to what I saw, and it's a particularly nice plan.
Shh.
going to someone else. You got pretty good. Can we go home now? I recorded it all back. It's still recording, actually.
You guys, thank you much for again. Well, this video may exceed 40 minutes, unfortunately, but I need to do this quick video. This is a quick roundup of most of the adequate things I found. For example, this is a button here, which you can quite obviously see. This is a bag seal with the that I didn't show you, with an inscription Jarvan, and on the reverse of that, it says Nexar of some variety. It's particularly old. Early 1800s of the early 19th century, obviously being Georgian, that of the earliest possible 1700s. It's some type of medieval loom weight here, particularly good. Some doorknob variety, that's how I found first. That was actually, I found this before that, the second find of significance anyway. And this massive belt buckle that I did not show you that my dad found. Unfortunately, this was an absolute beast of a buckle though. And, well, hope you enjoy. It should actually fit there, but it's misplaced itself over the years in the mineralized conditions it's been in. But yeah, other than that, guys, that is massive silver, one silver gilded buckle. But other than that, guys, in a bit.